Alright, what is up everyone? In this video, actually, this is gonna be one of the best video you will ever watch on YouTube because, you know what? For me, sometimes I really wanted to sleep but then I realized I did not farm the artifacts. So I'm like, oh crap, what should I do? I wish I knew all the efficiencies for the farming so that I can just kinda choose few places to get the most of the artifacts. So in this video, I'm gonna show you the efficiencies. I will show you how long it takes to farm the number of artifacts and then we will compare which place is the best to go if you're really, really busy or if you really wanna go to sleep, okay? So we'll start from the first location in Qingse Village. Let's go. From the teleport. That's 12 seconds for two. Well, I mean just one spot, okay? Because number of artifacts you get is random. That's two. What? What is that? What is this glitch? No! Give me the artifacts! No! My god, that was probably like 40 seconds, but this glitch kind of threw me off. No, give me! What is this? I didn't think this would be a entertaining video. Oh my god, let me go back and see if I can actually get that. Oh, please. Oh no, it's not there. It's not there. Actually, is it here? Oh, it is here. Okay, nice. Okay, next one. That was 19 seconds. Next location would be Saltare. I'm assuming that a lot of us will not have Mona, so we're just gonna try to swim, okay? Actually, can we just run? I think sprinting is faster than swimming. That's 1, 2, 3, 33 seconds. Wang Shuin. That's two spot. Sorry about that. Let me subtract like 2 seconds from that. So it was 1 minute and 12 seconds for three spots. We go to the stone gate. It was 14 seconds and Dragon Spine.
Believe in
25 seconds for 3. This place has 4 spots, and I wonder how long it actually takes for me to get there. That was less than 30 seconds for 4 spots. I would say this place is the most efficient place. You have to visit this place, even though you're really, really busy. Okay, hit this one. There's only 1 spot. Seconds for 1 spot. That's 1. 2. 30 seconds. Four. Five. 45 seconds. That was pretty good. For 15 seconds. And if we go to the other place right here, that would add up a lot of time and take down a lot of efficiencies. So what I can do, what I do, is I usually just skip this place, because that point right there gives you 1 only, and it adds a lot of time. ...42 seconds for 3 spots. Mount Elzang, let's go. I know that farming for artifacts is really, really boring and you don't want to do that, but let me remind you that getting all these artifacts will get you a lot of EXPs, and higher level artifacts will get your characters to be really strong. That's 1. 2, 31 seconds. And you may skip this route if you are busy. One minute and 10 seconds. Moving on to Juyun Karst. There are 2 places here. 1, 2 for 2 spots, that's 30 seconds. 3, 4. That's 5. And there's one more. So that was 5 for 57 seconds. It would depend on your, I would say your devices or PC. Because loading time also matters, right? And that is 6 for a minute and 15 seconds. That was quite nice. Let's go to Tianqi Valley. You know, it will take longer time if you kill those monsters or start, you know, killing those boars for meat. But because this video is just to show you how long it takes to go to each spot, I'm not gonna be doing that. It's one. Two. Three for 47 seconds. This one, I also kind of skipped a lot. Just because I had to like run a lot, but it's totally fine. It gives you 3. So that's 1, 2, 3 for 45 seconds. And this area has the most number of artifacts that they give you, so you should not miss out. But let's see how long it takes to get all these artifacts. 12 seconds in, I got the first one. 13. You're gonna have to run for a while. 14. I just noticed that I was using male character to run, but let me use Amber. 40 seconds, that's the second spot. 3rd. There's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. For 1 minute and 40 seconds. You have to go from this place. The one that I'm going to right now is my least favorite. It takes a long time and it's not very rewarding because it gives you only one. But let's see how inefficient it is for us to get that. But sometimes you get desperate, right? So it is always good to have it included in a video. What the f- Let's run. That was about 50 seconds, right? I got hit, got bounced back, so I'll say that was 50 seconds. And there's more you can get here, and it is the least efficient way to get the artifacts. This one as well, but I mean, you can get desperate, right? Oh, let's check out the last one. That was 20 seconds, and although it's not my favorite, let's go ahead and see how efficient it is. Let's take a look at the time it takes. We'll figure it out. We'll work things out. Okay, we can do this. All right, 50 seconds, I got one. Hands up, such a rush. I love having you here with me. To dream big is no sin. The sky has no limit, yeah, we're free. This town's too small for dreams like this. Don't wanna settle down, don't wanna miss out on adventure. Oh! Two minutes. So it's like 60 seconds to get one. After doing my daily routine, I was able to find out about the efficiencies. So what I did was I divided the total time it took from the teleport to the artifacts by the number of artifact points that I could get. So it is as follows. You should at least visit a place that takes less than 20 seconds per point, which is gonna be all the Dragonspine areas, Saltere, Stonegate, Qingsei Village, the one by Aozang, Huaguang Stone Forest. You should finish all the artifacts from Juyun Karst, west of Wangchuin. Surprisingly, Tiangchi Valley is pretty quick too, so you should get all these three. I hope this video helped you out a lot, because for me, sometimes I just want to go to sleep. I can't stand this boring process of farming for artifacts. So this video is for lazy people like you guys. I hope you guys don't miss out on those really efficient artifact farming points. Okay? Thank you so much for watching my video. If this video was helpful to you, please leave a like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys later. Adios!